According to Gloria Nawanyaga, the lockdown was the hardest time of their life and it cannot fade away.
When lockdown came, they cut off transport. Personally, my medication got done in lockdown. And I didn't have where to, you know, how to go and access my medication, you know. And even if they said that, you know, you can go to a nearby facility, I didn't have a nearby facility because most of them were far.
Through her foundation, Nawanyaga says a number of HIV patients were helped, but also many died because they could not access their drugs. Nawanyaga adds that the news of Ebola lockdown alone brings stigma to many in the affected region.
The post effects are there, that some people are still struggling financially, you know. Some people stopped taking medication, and when they stopped taking medication, they started developing AIDS. And that is something that doesn't go, you know, immediately. Some of them still have the symptoms. Some of them still have the AIDS. Some of them still have the mental health issues. Some of them committed suicide, you know. So, and also, they were talking about the increase of teenage pregnancies and all that. And they forgot that where someone got pregnant from, that is where HIV passes.
According to Hilary Nwamanya, riding a bicycle around delivery antiretroviral drugs to HIV persons during the lockdown was the only way he could contribute to the society.
I chose to be delivering medicines to other people. So since you understand, before it was strict, no transport, not public transport, and I had a bike and I had a passion to do my work. So I decided to, you know what, let me use the available resources so that I can save people's lives.
When COVID happened, there were disruptions to services, the access to testing declined, the access to antiretroviral therapy was disrupted for a short period while we adjusted.
The Ministry of Health says there is already a setup or plan for HIV patients to continue receiving their drugs during lockdown, as the Director of Uganda AIDS Commission, Dr. Nelson Mosova, explains.
We had to find a way to say, how do people continue getting their treatments? Your medication can even be brought to you, and somebody else can bring it, either a member of your group that you've agreed, or even the health facility.
Report compiled by John Musenze for the news.